Let's see if we can bring the team back. Today we're testing something, and that is how pay to win is the Peacekeeper in Hardcore. People said that this gun became overpowered as hell when it was released because of the nerf on the Razorback. And I'm here to tell you whether or not I believe that statement, really. I'm not a huge fan of Hardcore. I just don't like the whole camping aspect, where people just like to head glitch the whole time and wait back, like this player over here, who decided to go, which is thankful. I'm thankful for that. I don't want to find him anyway. I'm dead. I just shot my teammate, didn't I? No, I didn't. Okay. But I did. I'm kind of terrified at the moment. I'm not sure where my teammates are. I'm just going to pretend they're watching that way, and I'm going to watch this way now. We got the bomb down. One guy left. Now, in my opinion, one of the strongest weapons in Hardcore is the Dingo. I showed that before when I wanted to get the Chain Killer. I went on Nuketown with the Dingo, and I got the Chain Killer the first game. And I for some reason, that gun has an insanely long one-shot range. And, I mean, it is an LMG, I suppose, but with the fire rate of it, I wouldn't think that it would one-shot basically cross-map on any map, and it does, like, almost always. The one-shot range is, like, 150 yards. It's huge. It's on the level of the Razorback in terms of how broken it is. And that's what I always thought, like, the Dingo was the king of Hardcore. But, when this was released, people said, hey, check it out. It is, rather broken as well. Give it a shot. Walk in here and I'll shoot you. I know you're out there. I know you're out there. Don't you dare. I'm... Oh. Call this in. There's the bomb. Oh, now I know you're out there for sure. What was that? Like, you're just gonna sneak in? Alright, it's alright. We got it. Our teammates are doing the right thing here. They're flanking. Well, he just walked past one. Ah, it's all good. You got him still. Nice job, dudes. Nice job. That's why I kind of pushed out. I saw our team pinching around, but he, I think he knew where I was. He was hard-aiming the door pretty badly with that M8. And don't get me wrong, M8's still a good gun in this game mode. I wouldn't call it a game mode. Is it? No. Game modes are like Search and Destroy TDM. What is this? What do you call this? Core and Hardcore. This, I don't know. Whatever. It's good in Hardcore. The M8's good in Hardcore. The XR2 is good in Hardcore. None of these things are that bad. It's just that certain weapons do get quite a big buff when in this game mode. Or not game mode, but in this scenario in comparison to others. I'm dead. Where'd that grenade come from? He's lagging out. Oh, we might have lost here. I might have played too aggressive. Looks like the rest of our team is in the back of our spawn. And this is why I don't really like to play Hardcore. This is pretty much what you get. You know? These two guys never made it past the first building. This dude actually turned around and walked backwards to lay in a corner in the grass. This dude's lagging out. Can't really help it. But this is why I never liked playing Hardcore. I have no fun watching people camp, and I have no fun playing against people that camp. And I would say, from my experience playing, when the time to kill is very quick, and you can look at Hardcore as an example, or you can look at even a game like Ghosts, which just had a fast time to kill overall, people like to play very slow. They're very scared to go move around and play the game. Ooh, rejack paying off right there. They're very scared to go around and play the game when it's too easy to die. And I can understand that logic, but because of that, it's not very fun. At least, in my opinion. I know some people think that, hey, Hardcore is better because it doesn't, you know, you don't have to kill people, you don't have to shoot people a bunch. They die when you kill them, or right when you shoot them. That, in my opinion, is false. I don't think Core is that bad when it comes to shooting people. And, you know, you hit them 3 times, 4 times, sure. But very rarely do I shoot people. He's gonna die from falling. Very rarely do I shoot people to the point where I think they should have died and they didn't, you know? I got one there. And that wraps up the game. Solid. Solid game there. We're gonna try a game with one more map. We did okay. I'm entitled, honestly, just off the first impressions of using it. I've never played Hardcore with this gun. I just kind of got the gun and was like, alright, cool, let's use it. In Core, it's not that good. It's just a little bit better than the ICR, which is like the worst rifle in the class in terms of time to kill. But in hardcore, it has a little bit more damage than the ICR, so the one-shot range is much further. And the fire rate's the same, the recoil's pretty low. I'm using grip, because I feel like grip is more important on a gun like this than anything else I could use anyway. So, overall, first impressions is it's pretty fucking strong. I'm gonna give it another shot on a different map, though. I'll fast forward till we're in the next game. All right, let's see how it works on a level like this. It looks like we got the same team, roughly, so expect the same. It will probably be sketchy at best. And I am not very good at carrying in hardcore, so this is going to be difficult, I would say. Oh, there's a two-shot. That was a big distance, too, though, for a two-shot to happen. Oh, shit! Dude's got a rocket. Oh, but he came back for me. Oh, that rocket was close. That rocket was close as shit. Our teammate went in right there at the brekkie. He had fucking no fear. Seriously, no fear in the world. That dude with the M8 wanted it. He's like, I'm coming back and challenging you. I don't care if I'm in the middle of a reload. That doesn't matter. All right, up 1-0. I'm already happy at this point. I shouldn't probably, I don't know, I guess I don't have the greatest expectations. Last game was not exactly balanced in my opinion, but whatever. Let's give it a shot here. This should be about the two-shot range as well, I assume. Oh, I died in the fall! Fuck, no! I was gonna point out, he hit-markered me with a Razorback. That's important to think about. The Razorback didn't have the one-shot range like it used to, so he couldn't one-shot me. He hit-markered me, which gave me a chance to jump, turn, and kill him, and I could one-shot him. That's huge. That is interesting. I like looking at that kind of stuff, because you see the distance of the gun that used to be the king of hardcore compared to the gun that is released via supply drops now, and my gun did better. That's... Oh, wow. I haven't tested the exact distance of a one-shot in hardcore, nor do I think any YouTuber really has. I don't think even Drifter has done an in-depth on specific one-shot distances of certain guns in hardcore, which is actually, like I said, very interesting to me, because it supports the pay-to-win model, which I totally don't agree with in Black Ops 3. Like, I don't think it actually exists. I think the game is more pay-to-have-fun, because obviously getting new weapons is fun, and you can play with them and enjoy them, but... Not up to this point, I wouldn't say many weapons. You're so dead. Up to this point, you're dead. Oh my god, he's dead. Not many weapons have been so good that I would call them pay to win. The only one that I would really put up there, and I'm gonna sneeze in a second, I'm trying to avoid it. Oh my god, stop. Ugh. The only one I would say is the Marshall. The Marshall is absurdly annoying to die to, and not many guns in the game can challenge it because the shotguns in the game don't one-shot like the Marshals do. Like, the KRM isn't as good enough. It just isn't good enough. So that's the only gun I would put near the pay-to-win category. The other ones are interesting. They're probably fun to use. I've had fun using them, but they're not very good. The RSA Interdiction is bad. The DBSR is bad. I mean, it's just overall, most of the guns are not that good. Dude, I don't want to peek out. I'm tired of rockets flying past me, man. That is the two-shot range again. That's pretty far, though. I mean, seriously, that's not like a close-range... Oh, wow. Thank you, Mr. M8. Mr. Brails, I appreciate that, my friend. One more here. Got him. Nothing. Push up. Got two left. Teammate's got the middle with his M8. Nicely played. And I'll shoot him in the back once. That works. That's still pretty good one-shot distance, though. I mean, some of these distances, I will say, the Dingo is still better. But the LMG has a downside, okay? Just as all LMGs do. Even with quick draw, the ADS speed is still pretty slow. Probably, I would say, 2 times slower than the Peacekeeper. If you use quick draw on both guns, I think it's about 2 times slower. I looked it up at one point, so I could tell you. But the average rifle ADS speed is much quicker than the average LMG. So, That's why I say that. Alright, let's move up here. Alright, got those two. UAV. Alright, looks like we're pretty good. And they're both in the back, got them both. Solid game, 11-1. So, the downside of using a Dingo, despite it being the best gun in my opinion in terms of one-shot range and how good overall, good ammo size, good fire rate, one-shot's insane. The downside is that the Dingo's ADS speed and strafe speed are slower than rifles, which make it a little bit worse when it comes to reaction time and when it becomes like out-strafing bullets, which is hard in hardcore. It's not easy, but it can happen. So, the Dingo, in my opinion, still takes the cake for number one, especially for respawn because of the ammo size. It's insane. But I would say for search, the Peacekeeper is pretty fucking crazy, all right? Like, way, 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 way better than the Razorback used to be now. Well, not Razorback now. Razorback, what it used to be, probably fairly similar, actually. But that's insane. I didn't believe in the pay-to-win stuff that much. I've seen this gun, but I've never used it in hardcore, and although I did get two instances where I was at the distance to two-shot, a majority of the time I one-shot. Majority. So, and I think at the distance that I was at the two-shot range, most other rifles, except possibly the Man O' War, would have been two-shot as well. That's pretty crazy. I'm getting up there in the list as well. Hell yeah. Thank you guys for watching, though. If you guys have any idea on that, and the reason why I kind of wanted to address this was because Advanced or Infinite Warfare is coming out. We have the beta next month. I'm not sure if weapon variants will be in the beta or not, but weapon variants have been announced. People have seen them. There are pictures all over. You can check them out. I don't want to put any in the video because I'm afraid to show things like that still, but I feel like pay to win's going to happen again, and as sad as it is, but you just got to be ready for it, I suppose. Even if you don't believe or think what you just saw was fair, it's going to be very similar in the next game. Thank you guys again, though. I appreciate the love, and I will see you all later.